Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering Advancement channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 42 for our valuable viewers. And in today's lecture, we will be moving to chapter number 8, which is Multiple Reactions from the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by H. Scott Fogler. In today's course coverage, we will first have an overview of this chapter, that why this chapter is important in context of our concepts related to chemical reaction engineering, and then we will discuss some basic terms related to this chapter. So far, we have studied single reactions, like we can say A plus B goes to C, or A goes to B, or A plus B goes to C plus D, and so on. But these are the single reactions. And once we talk about the industrial aspects or the real-time aspects, the single reactions are very rare in the system. However, the multiple reactions which are included are too often or more often in the system, in which we say that our desired product is formed and then there is an undesired or byproduct is formed in the system. Like we can say that A plus B produces C. If we just consider it, then the story is not completed. We have to consider the other reactions, like A plus B also produces D, or maybe E or F, and so on. So this is the real-time scenario. But before coming to this scenario, we must have some understanding so that we will be able, or we should be able, to adopt it in an easy way. So the key element in the economic success of a chemical plant is the minimization of undesired side reactions that occur along with the desired reaction. As I have said, that if C is your desired product and D is your undesired product, economically, feasibly, C should be produced more in this reaction and D less quantity. So if you do not consider D and if you do all calculations on C, then the calculations will remain incomplete, and obviously you won't be able to get the optimal design. And we have already studied this diagram in our lecture number 1, where we have said that there is a trade-off between the reaction system and the separation system. We want to have an optimal design where the separation cost and the reactor cost is optimized in the system. So this is the overall overview that why multiple reactions need to be considered. And without considering the multiple reactions, or assuming that we can ignore something, the system, the calculations will remain incomplete. So basic definitions for this chapter include the parallel reactions, series, complex, and independent reactions. Parallel reactions are those reactions in which the reactant is consumed by two different reaction pathways to produce products. Like you can say A goes to B and then the similar A goes to C. So there are multiple pathways included. In the series reaction, that the reaction where the reactant forms an intermediate product which further reacts to form an other product, like A produces B and then B produces C. If you see these two, K1 is the rate constant for conversion of A to B, and K2 is the rate constant for conversion of A to C. However, here K1 is same as that of parallel one, but K2 represents the intermediate product conversion to C. So the definition of the rate constant in both the cases is a bit different. In complex reaction, we can say it is a combination of series and parallel reactions. Like you can see that A and B reacts to produce C and D, and then that A reacts with C to produce E. So the parallel and the series aspects both are covered in it. And then the independent reactions, no connection with each other. Multiple reactions are occurring, but there is no connection between each other. Like you can see that A produces B and C, and another species D which produces another species E and F. So the multiple reactions which occur at the same time, but neither the products nor reactants react with themselves or one another. So these are the four different types of reactions which are included in the system. Now, if you see here that I have discussed it earlier, that we want to maximize the formation of desired product, well, we want to minimize the formation of undesired product. Let's assume that desired product is represented by D, undesired product is represented by U. So A goes to D, which the reaction rate constant as K1, A goes to U, which is represented as reaction rate constant represented as K2. So obviously, the more will be the desired product, the economically feasible will be that plant, and the lesser will be the desired product, thus less feasible will be the system. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.